I don't even know if it does. I'm here, so I don't know. I just don't want to talk about it. I'm really, really pleased with this club. No, really, really, I really love it.
Don't let the fact that this is a really good valued SBC and also the first French SBC player we've gotten in all of FIFA 22 distract you from the fact that not only did Andy cheat in yesterday's Squad Builder Showdown yesterday, whom he probably learned really well from Mitani, aka Cheatani, but also isn't it kind of interesting and isn't it kind of a coincidence that Robert Lewandowski was cheated out of the Ballon d'Or and then also Andy cheated in the Squad Builder Showdown featuring the team at the group stage Lewandowski? Your Honor, I rest my case. What's happening, boys, and welcome to the Etienne René Capoue episodia. That is right, today we get ourselves a team of the group stage, 87 Villarreal, Etienne Capoue, a very deserved card, not a live item. I always get these questions on these blue cards. If it doesn't have like a fancy little thing going down the side of the card, and if it doesn't have like the fancy artwork surrounding the card, they're not live items. This is a static card. He stays 87. Whatever happens to Villarreal, he is going to stay. He is going to stay this exact reason. I am going to brand him the Tesco Vieira, who is an icon who obviously every version of his card goes for hella coins. This is a card that actually favors, that compares very favorably to the 88 rated card. Obviously the 88 has that 85 pace. And then the craziest thing about this card is the fact that it is a 351 total in-game stat upgrade over his base. I believe it's a, is it a 23? It's not a 23 overall. It's not a 23 overall upgrade. He's got plus 28 pace over his base card, which has 48. And he's got a whopping plus 47 agility. This might be the single biggest single stat upgrade that we've ever seen on any card, maybe ever, and it turns him, it takes him from the likes of a player that's not even fodder. He's a non-rare, obviously, which basically is just 75 plus PP fodder, goes from being just minimal fodder to being a card that has the most total in-game stats among any of the La Liga CMs. And today we are going to find out, is he fast enough to play in the meta of FIFA 22? We're going to take him through his paces in Division 4. Am I going to milk Andy cheating for all it's worth? You're damn right. You want to know what else I'm going to milk? The fact that we opened up a merch store yesterday. If you guys have ever watched any Epi and have partaken in the Zwei School of Pens, well, that Zwei School of Pens that I founded almost 2 years ago, we have a hat, we have a shirt, and we have a hoodie. It's all on sale right now, available until December 15th, and then the pre-orders cut off. Shipping will go out early January. The link will be in the description below. If you agree that Andy cheated, pick up yourself a hat. If you think that Robert Lewandowski was robbed of the 2020 Ballon d'Or, pick yourself up a hoodie. Also, if you think Nick is hella old, get yourself that damn t-shirt. Merch link in the description. I can't believe, I thought Jake Paul was only allowed to say stuff like that. Smash like on the Epi if you think this is a pretty good value SBC. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. And as Philly DeFranco says, let's just hop right into it. So what do you get? You get 6'3", you get medium already. That's pretty beefy. He has the high and average body type. He's got the three star, which is a little bit meh. But then we go look at the stats. And if you start on the left, you might think to yourself, a little bit underwhelming. 79 acceleration, goes up to 89 with the shadow, goes up to 84 sprint speed with the shadow. So from that perspective, I think he'll be fine. 88 attacking positioning, which is pretty damn decent. 79 finishing, which is pretty damn decent. 87 shot power with 83 long shots. Even has a cheeky little bit of volleying on him. Passing stats, 87 vision, 90 short passing, 88 long passing. That's obviously some of the most important stuff. 76 curve, little bit meh. Wish that was maybe over 80, but maybe we're nitpicking there. And then you look at the dribbling stats for a guy that has this beefiness. 80 agility, plus 47 agility compared to the base card. Has the 80 balance, has the 88 reactions, has the 87 ball control, 84 dribbling, has a bit of composure, and then the defensive stats and the physical stats are why you pick this card up. You want him to run your midfield. You want him to be a guy that can just pretty much beast out. Goes up to 99 interceptions, goes up to 90 defensive awareness, goes up to 97 standing tackle, and then 98 sliding tackle, 86 stamina, 87 strength. And then the only thing I'll say is the aggression is a little bit low and no traits. But for a player that's 65K, can't really complain about that. Other thing you can't complain about is the fact that he gets very, very good links and gonna have Capoue on balanced and cover center. But without any further ado, boys, match number one, Alès. All right, boys, match number one, we're coming up against a Sar. We're coming up against a Foden. He's got Tavernier. Not the craziest looking squad, right? So I'm expecting to kind of run this one, but first thing we want to test out is the dribbling. High and average body type. Doesn't feel super silky on the ball, to be honest with you. But, yeah, the acceleration isn't immense, but you're expecting that with a, you're expecting that with a Capoue, right? You're not expecting them. And then you get the ball in Benzema's feet, and he's just absolutely wilding. You got Kante, nice little ball to feet with Capoue. Runs around. I don't even know what. Yeah. Doesn't feel rapid, does he? Yeah, he looked, you know what? I would go so far as to say, why does it look like, is he going fast at least? Or does it just look like he's going slow? Kapoor. Defensive jockeying. Nice standing tackle. Feels a little bit like Nicolas Zule's card. And again, I just want to get him some touches so I can see how he feels. Again, he's not a burner, right? I'm almost wondering if it's worth putting an engine on him, maybe? I don't know. Damn, dude. We concede. Not the craziest looking squad, right? So I'm expecting to kind of run this one, but test out the sprint speed again. Can he burn by whoever that is? That's Kai Havertz. I mean, he's moving. Not the craziest looking squad, right? So I'm expecting to kind of run this one, but are we actually losing? Dude, Zula's frame is so wide. The girth is so unprecedented. Cool with the nice interceptions. See what I mean? Like Hyungmin Son, he's got no chance of catch. I mean, that's obviously Hyungmin Son, but he doesn't have a prayer's chance of catching up with him.
He'd love to score before the 2-minute warning. Checks it down to Lockett.
What is wrong with this game?
So he would have liked to catch that.
This game's, oh my God, stop cheating me, man. Just stop.
Okay, Thierry Henry, come on, boys. So he's running. Nice little slide. Nice little challenge right there. Kapoor winning the ball back there. Referee, grow a set of nuts, you little Gerber graduate, man. Yeah, Kapoor was the one lone bright spot. I think I probably won the most standing tackles I ever have in a game. 9 standing tackles, 6 standing tackles, 67% success rate. I'm thinking maybe Hunter might be the play, bro. I feel like it's kind of messed up that we don't have him linked into Parejo. I feel like we got to run him with one game. I feel like we have to run him one game with Parejo, but then he doesn't work though. We keep the shadow on him, and then Parejo still already has the goated. Okay, you know what? Yeah, let's do that. Not the craziest looking squad, right? So I'm expecting to kind of run this one, but and Parejo's the guy that can kind of get forward. Then there's Kapu with the hard challenge. Neres. There we go. Yeah. I mean, Kapu's that guy. You're gonna launch yourself into guys with Kapoor. Navas, Kapoor. Oh! Little bit of wiggle there. Who was that? Was that Youngberg? Oh!
So he would have liked to catch that.
This game's. Oh my God! Stop cheating me, man. Just stop!
And then that's... Did that go off? No, that went off his keeper.
Just stop!
Like, man, that's gotta be... Bro, that's so... Come on, there we go, Thierry Henry. 2-1. Come on, boys. The comeback is on. Benzema and Henry, come on, boys. The two top French goal scorers of all time. I think Benzema recently equalized or did better than Thierry Henry in terms of French international striker, in terms of strength. New nationality, strength. Thierry Henry. Looking as rapid as ever. And then a cheeky Karim the Dream Benzema. 3-2, boys. In a matter of, what is that, 10 in-game minutes? Go ahead and bang in 3 goals unanswered. You love to see it. The French connection is strong. Imagine this is your job and in the first 2 games you're wondering why you're possibly losing. And it's because you freaking have Jesus Navas as your right center back again, man. Now that That is peak FIFA 22. When you're playing FIFA 22 properly, that's what you're capable of.
You're now listening to the Chris Kapoy.
Got him!
Yeah, he always sticks that damn leg out and gets the ball away. Consistently is able to do that. Yeah, nice little bit of strength there to get around the defender. Left analog stick dribbling. But here's where, I mean, would you consider that fast? Who's that catching up to him? Kapoy! Yo, what the hell? Kapoy going on an absolute little... Etienne René Kapoy going on an absolute little skill run. Is that going to be game? That might be game, set, match, boys. This is to all the Zule doubters. That's Vinicius. That's one of the most agile players in the game. And that's just Nicolas Zule just not taking anything from anyone. You know what I mean? He's got the body type. Absolutely massive. Get up in that deal. Boys, we're going to the Zwei School of Pens. What's his pens? Etienne Kapoy. It's going so slow. The Zwei School of Pens, you switch to another guy, you wait for a couple seconds, making him think you're going to go left or right, and then you're going to go ahead and you're going to do a Panenka. That's LB and then circle, and it works.
So smart!
It works every time. The Zwei School of Pens merch is available. Merch link in description. He rage quit. So you get a premium mixed players pack and a small Electrum player pack. Again, both tradable. That's a dub. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to say, in terms of value, for 60,000 coins, I'm going to say that the value is about a 4 out of 5. I'm really close to giving it a 3.5, but because he's so damn cheap, because you get two tradable packs back, most total in-game stats among any player in La Liga. The fact that La Liga is starved a little bit for a guy that kind of has the stats that he has, medium, a guy that can help out defensively. Casemiro a little bit too slow, so I think this is maybe the new best defensive mid. You have guys like Llorente and Parejo that are going to get a little bit more involved in the attack. The fact that this is a 60,000 coin card and you get some of that value back from the tradable packs is just a dub in my opinion. So 4 out of 5 in terms of value. However, when we get to the on the pitch performance, I'm going to give him a 3.5 out of 5 because initially you see the card and you're like, okay, this looks like a super versatile card. He just, it might be the body type. He doesn't move super fast. Yeah, he was a little, there was some agility that we showcased in that third match. Yeah, we showcased that we could score with him, but he's very much as diverse and has like as spread out as his stats are. I feel like he's more of a CDM. He's not a true box-to-box. He's a facilitator, has some really, really good passing stats, but even then, the 76 curve, a little bit meh. Might want to get the engine chem style on there, but still felt that the pace was just a little bit sluggish, and I think that you're just going to want to run him as a CDM. So for me, more of a CDM, less of a box-to-box, 3.5 out of 5 in terms of on-the-pitch performance, just a little bit sluggish, but again, I don't think you're going to be too disappointed with him if you play him in that stay-back role with maybe a Parejo. If you've already completed him, you have a go to little La Liga combo right there. So value really good on the pitch performance. He was pretty good. That is gonna do it for the episode, you boys. Just giving you my thoughts on the Kapoy. We've got the versus. We got the versus promo come tomorrow, which I'm super super excited about. Looks like Pulisic might be the SBC or one of the main cards headlining the event. Smash like on the EP if you guys did enjoy. Remember, merch link is in the bio if you guys want to pick up some Zwei School of Pens merch. Will be available until December 15th and then ships out early January. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Andy's a fraud. Catch you guys for another upload tomorrow. Till next time, boys. Tschüss. Later. Ade.